Imam Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah has said this, that the soul now will travel, and it will be in different souls have different stations. If it's a bad soul, then its soul will go to Sijjin, a place called Sijjin, a lowly place where all these souls are being punished. Or it will stay in the grave, it depends on Allah. But it will not leave this world. It may stay even on this earth. Sometimes the soul is not maybe not being punished, but it's not a good soul. Allah will not allow it to go above the universe. But if you're a good soul, the soul basically gets a station above. What happens here is Allah will put the soul into Illiyin. If you want to read about this, read Surah Mutaffifin in the 83rd Surah of the Quran. Where the soul will go into, it depends, okay, how high it is. Either Allah will just put it in Illiyin. Now what happens in Illiyin? One hadith describes this. That when this all has happened in the grave, when all this has happened, then Allah allows the soul to be raised. And it goes to Illiyin. When it's coming to Illiyin, your family members, my family members, if we're good souls, they start to ask, people start to ask in Illiyin, another soul, who is it? And the name says, so-and-so, the son of so-and-so. Your father, your grandfather, your great-grandfather, whoever they are, your great-grandmother, whoever they are, they will basically come to the front of the doors of Illiyin. They will open their arms to receive you, la ilaha illallah. And you will come and they will grab hold of you. They will hug you. Only if we're good souls. And they will say, according to the hadith come from our Prophet's mouth, they will say, how is so-and-so in the world? How is your son? How is my other daughter? How is your sister? How is so-and-so? I left them. What is the latest news that's going on in the world? And they will embrace you, grace you, and bring you into Illiyin. Now that's a high station. But Imam Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah said, within Illiyin there are stages. You can be in a very high stage in Illiyin. Or you can be in the middle, or you can be in low stage, depending on your state. And if you go to a very high stage in Illiyin, you've got a lot more room to move around. Allah may give you permission to go around the other heavens. Allah may give you permission to visit this world and go back. Especially the shaheed. In a sahih hadith of Muslim, the one who is a shaheed, Allah will put their soul into a green bird. And it's clear, Rasulullah said, that green bird will roam around the heavens, will go over Jannah, look at Jannah, fly over Jannah, will go and sit at one of the lanterns next to the arsh and the throne of Allah. That's the width Allah has given to the shaheed. So this bird is basically roaming around over Jannah, in the heavens and so on. There's a station above this. Imam Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah says, and this is all from ahadith. He says that's the station of the Anbiya, station of the prophets. And he gives the dalil. The dalil is very clear. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Mi'raj, and he went to Masjid al-Aqsa, who did he see there? The prophets. These were not the prophets in their bodily form. They were prophets in the form of their souls. When a sahih hadith of Muslim, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was passing over the grave of Musa alayhi salam, and he saw Musa alayhi salam praying in his grave. Same sahih, another sahih hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to Muslim, he was on the sixth heaven. He saw Musa alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam was the one who told him that go back and ask your Lord to take these 50 salahs down until he became 5 salahs. Yes or no? How did he see Musa alayhi salam in his grave? He saw Musa alayhi salam in Masjid al-Aqsa, and he saw Musa alayhi salam up in the sixth heaven in the same night. These are all sahih narrations. How? This is the extent of the Anbiya. The Anbiya have got the greatest traveling that they can do. In fact, if they want to remain in the graves, they remain in the graves. If they want to go to some heaven, they can go to some heaven. If they want to go to the highest of abode, they can go to the highest of abode. This is the soul of the Anbiya.